Greetings, traveler, and welcome back to the Lapis Kingdom. I am the Blue Regent, and on today's survival episode, we're going to be talking about something a little bit different. Today's focus is going to be food security in the game. So if you're ready, saddle up, and let's begin. All right, so if you watched last week's building episode, you know that we spent some time building up some farming areas. And today what we're going to be doing is using what we've created to get some animal farms going. So we've got a pig sty over here and a cow pasture over here. Now, if you are new to Minecraft, a thing that you should know is that different types of vegetables attract different types of animals. So wheat will attract cows and sheep. So I'm going to use this wheat to attract this cow all the way over here. Now, if you've played this game before, you know that this isn't always the easiest thing to do. They lose interest in what you're carrying after a while, and eventually will kind of stop following you. So you kind of have to like wait and try again. But first try, first shot. And I just dragged this cow straight into the pond. And then I'm going to run over here and shut it. And just like that, our cow pasture has one cow. Now, there's two cows over here. So let me see. Actually, I'm going to pick up this egg real quick. Let me see if I can get both of these cows with this piece of wheat. So I've got one cow. I've got two cows, maybe. Yep. So now they're going to follow me. Now, they will get stuck on blocks. They will get lost. And it is annoying, but you kind of just have to be a little persistent. Okay, I still got them. So I'm just going to drag these guys in. This cow that we already dragged in is also interested in the wheat we're carrying. And so now I've got three cows in the pasture. Now, having cows is nice because, you know, I can use them. I can use a bucket to milk them. Did I get two? I got two milks. This is a good antidote if you get poisoned by something. If you get poisoned by something, or later on when you fight pillagers, and you get the bad omen, you can use this to get rid of that negative effect. So that's what you can do with cows, but you can also kill cows. They'll give you leather and they'll give you raw beef. So that's what you can do with the cows that you already have. But another thing you can do with cows and wheat is I can right-click this cow, I can right-click this cow, and they'll go to each other and they'll kiss, I guess, and I get a baby cow. Look at that. So I can actually create a little cow farm over here, and you get experience for breeding livestock, and eventually I can have a bunch of cows built up. So that's the cool thing about that. Now I have this pig that somehow bizarrely got trapped in here when we were building the pasture, so I'm gonna have him follow me, and we're gonna head over to our pigsty over here where we already have one pig. Just like this. And of course, oh, and we snagged an extra pig. Oh, this is what I was talking about. So they'll lose interest in you if you get too far away, or if you've been trying to lure them for too long. Eventually they'll stop paying attention, so you kind of just have to re-get their attention. So we're gonna bring these pigs in here just like this. Let me open both fences or gates. Great, so now I've got three pigs in our pigsty. There's another pig over there. So as far as I can tell, I've gotten all of the pigs in the immediate area, but four pigs is more than enough to get going. Basically you need only two of anything. Now, they are attracted to potatoes, as you've already seen. They are also attracted to carrots. And I believe they're also attracted to beetroots. And just like the cows, I can pair them off. And I can get little baby pigs. So now I can use this as ultimately a food source. But also it kind of just helps. Anytime you're trying to build a village, it just kind of helps it feel more alive to have animal farms around. Now, when you breed your animals, they do have a cool down period between when you can breed them again. You can't just sit there and spam feeding them and have them, create new ones nonstop. So this is the simplest way to have like a livestock farm in Minecraft is basically capture two of something, put it in an enclosure, and then use the types of food that they like to breed them. So this is the simplest livestock, and pigs and cows are both really great food sources. Pigs will drop pork chops, cows will drop steaks, and they're pretty low maintenance. And so now we're going to talk about chickens. Just like the cows and the pigs, chickens, you can also attract them with a food item, and what they are attracted to is wheat seeds. Now, chickens are kind of tricky and they're hard to get to follow. And a bonus to chickens is they drop eggs, or they produce eggs. And eggs, if you right click them, oops, you can throw them, and there is a. Well, that makes me sad. Okay, well, everything about what just happened is depressing. But as you can see, you can throw eggs, and when you throw eggs, there's a certain percent chance that they will then spawn a baby chicken, which is just what happened there. But I think I got it when it spawned in the like in between blocks, and so that was very unfortunate and kind of depressing. But there is a solution to this. I do know that there is a chicken running around over here. Let's see if we can find it. Now, if you don't watch any other Minecraft players, a good piece of advice for you when you're first starting, and I learned this from, I think it Gemini Tay talks this about this in one of her videos. There is a chicken around here. Haha. Okay. So wheat seeds is what they're attracted to. Now this is gonna be a pain because we're heading a pretty far distance with this chicken. Come on. Come on. But Gemini Tay talks about resist the urge to kill all the animals around you when you first start a world because you don't have to do as much dragging stuff around as you would. Like if I had killed all those cows and all those pigs and this chicken to get food, I would have had food right away. But I also would have had to have traveled farther to find new ones for setting up these farms. So that's a lot of work. And as you can see, I'm kind of getting lucky on getting them to follow me, but it's not always the easiest thing to do. And yep, it's not always the easiest thing to do. And imagine doing this a pretty far distance. It would be kind of a pain. So the more you can save yourself the time, let's see if I can get you. This is why I was hoping the egg thing would have worked. I'm gonna do. Well, the chicken's gone. I lost the chicken's interest. There we go. That's how I want to do this. I want a little platform that I'm going to walk on. So, okay. So, if I could have gotten the egg thing to work, that would have been great. But it didn't. And so now I have to get kind of, I have to outsmart this weird system. Come on, chicken. Ha-ha! Nailed it. So now this chicken is in here. And I'm just gonna throw that right there for now. So that chicken's in there, and that chicken is just going to continue to lay eggs forever. It happens not that often, but often enough to where this chest will start to, over time, fill up with eggs. And I can use those other eggs to then put more chickens in there. If you have four chickens in one of these coops, they're gonna produce more. I feel feel like I just heard it lay an egg. Is it working? Maybe I'm hearing things. But basically, each of these hoppers can hold a certain stack of stuff, and or a certain amount of stacks of stuff, and that chest can hold it. So if you have four chickens in there, that's going to produce more than enough eggs for you. Now, once I get two chickens in there, which let me see if there's any other chickens around. Once I get two chickens in there, I can do the same thing that I did with the pigs, same thing that I did with the cows. If I feed both of them one piece of the wheat seeds, then they both will produce a baby chicken. And then I basically just have an infinite egg source, which you use eggs to make cake, you use eggs to make pumpkin pie, which are both really good food sources later on, because different foods have different saturation values. I'm currently eating baked potatoes. I wouldn't say that they're the best food item, but they're a pretty decent early game food item. They give you, you know, a couple bars of hunger, plus the saturation value on them is a little bit higher than some other food items. Let me see. Also, just so everyone knows, I found this the other day. Look at this, it's a pink sheep. The percent chance of these spawning is super, super rare. So when I saw it, I trapped it. Eventually, I'm going to move it into the town, but I'm not there yet. And once we start getting this far out of town, it starts just getting harder and harder. Oh, look at all these chickens. Okay, so I'm only going to need three of these, but I'm going to have all of them start following me. And if I lose one, if I lose one, I lose one. So we're just going to head, hey, everybody, we're going to head this way. Come on. Come on. We haven't even gone that far. You guys can do it. Hi, sheep. I'm pretty sure I'm not going to fall in any lava, but I am not necessarily going the direction I want to be going. Okay. Let's go, team. Yep, now we're all going to go down the hill. Okay, well, we lost one. That is all right. As long as we get one to town, that's all that matters. So we made it back. That was a lot. And now I'm gonna bring these two chickens up. Oh no. Everything's falling apart. Okay, alright. Alright. Nobody saw that. Come on, chickens. Come on, chickens. this is turning into my nightmare. Okay, let's shut this. It's almost nighttime. It's a little nerve-wracking. Did all of them get out? Okay. So the one chicken got out, and the other two outsmarted me. But we're all here, and that's one chicken in. That's two chickens in. Come on, chicken. Come on, chicken. You know what? That's enough. I've got two chickens in here. Oh. No! Okay, so I was just slow enough. Ugh, everything about what's creeping me out, what's happening right now is creeping me out. I was just slow enough to get to my bed that now I've got all these mobs running around. And I don't really have any weapons on me right now because I wasn't thinking I was going to be doing any fighting this episode. But I'm trying to get this last chicken in here. Come on. Okay, well, that's cool. Thank you. There we go. Oh, I didn't want to shut that yet. Okay, so I've got three chickens in here, and the goal is four. So I'm going to feed you maybe one of you. Can I feed any of you? Feed you. I fed them both. Baby chicken. So now there are four chickens in here. I'm going to seal this up. Working chicken coop. Now, over time, as I get more eggs, I can kind of throw a couple of them around so that I have a couple chickens running around out here too. That'll look nicer. But in the meantime, this is going to do its job. See, I've already got two eggs in here, and they are good to go. So there's our egg farm, chicken farm. It's not really a chicken farm necessarily, but if I put some eggs inside of the coop, it will turn into more of a chicken farm. And what you get from chickens are basically raw chicken and feathers, and the feathers you can use for arrows, which is going to be really good, because I'm kind of running low on arrows. The last type of food that we're going to talk about today, as far as survival stuff goes, is going to be fish. Now, there are two ways that you can gather fish as food in Minecraft. The easiest, and I say this easiest only because it doesn't really require any tools, and you can do this as soon as you start in the game, is to attack fish. And it's kind of silly, but all I have to do is swim up to this fish, and I've got my sword equipped right now, but I'm just gonna swipe at it, and I get one fish. I can also do this with a bare hand, so if you literally spawn into the game, you can just start swimming around, punching fish, and you get a little bit of experience, and you get a fish. Now, that's easy because you don't have to have the equipment to get, or you don't have to have any special kind of equipment to do that, but there are better, more efficient time-wise ways to fish. So I've got my crafting table out here, and we're gonna make a fishing pole. The way that you make a fishing pole is I need three sticks going at an angle, and I believe I can actually do this in either direction. And then I need two pieces of string, and I'm basically making the shape of a fishing pole, and I can't do that in either direction. So there's no set way this can face either direction, but it creates a fishing rod for me. And basically, any body of water in the game, you can, if you right click with your fishing pole equipped, you'll cast out your lure, and you notice the little bubble particles start to appear on the water. And I'm just gonna kind of sit here to wait, sit here and wait. And there's like a whole bunch of information online if you're interested on, the different things that affect the rate at which fish appear. But you'll see the trail of bubbles coming. My lure goes under. I right click again, and I catch a fish. So again, I'll cast out. All these little particle effects start to appear on the water. I'll wait, and it's kind of there's a range in time in which it happens, but eventually there's our trail of bubbles. Lure goes under, I right click again, and I caught another cod. So this is handy because I don't have to go swimming, I don't have to worry about my oxygen levels or anything like that. And at the same time, I'm still getting fish, and it's not affecting the durability of my weapons. Or I don't have to chase the fish around. So I can just kind of sit here just like this and fish, and this is a nice way if you've, spent some time underground, kind of struggling, fighting some mobs, and you want to keep playing, but you need a little break from fighting. This is a nice, relaxing way to do that, and at the same time, you're getting experience and food. I've been fishing for about 10 minutes, and if you notice, I've got some new stuff in my hot bar down here. I've got some more salmon, some more cod. Those can be cooked and eaten. I have some more tropical fish, which can be cooked and eaten. However, these are really good for trading with villagers. So when we ultimately get our trading hall set up, that's what that's going to be used for. There's also pufferfish and tropical fish, and the other two types of fish can all be used to tame cats and breed cats. In Java, which we're playing is what we're playing, you can also use pufferfish to befriend the ocelots, which creepers are afraid of. But I also caught these things, and this is my favorite part about fishing, and this is why fishing is my favorite way of gathering food in this game. I got two enchanted books and an enchanted fishing rod. Now, you can get other items. Sometimes you'll get boots. I always think it's funny when I catch leather boots in Minecraft. You can catch lily pads, which you can use for decoration. Sometimes you can catch like water bottles. But I can use both of these enchanted books on items. Quick charge is a crossbow enchantment that you can use. Loyalty works for tridents when we get one of those. Efficiency works for any item that gathers stuff. So like a pickaxe, a shovel, an axe. Unbreaking works for anything that has durability. So these are items that with a anvil, I can give these special effects too. The pufferfish I can also use to make water breathing potions a little bit farther down the line when we start potion brewing. So fishing, all in all, in my opinion, is the one that you get the most bang for your buck as far as ways to get food, because you also get a bunch of other very helpful items. The only catch to it is it requires string to make a fishing pole, and sometimes that's a little difficult to get your hands on early game. Now that we have our cow pasture and pigsty set up, our chicken coop going, and a fishing pole that we can get fish with, we're pretty set as far as food goes. Next survival episode, we're going to talk about how we can make it through Minecraft and an entirely vegetarian diet as well, for those of you who are feeling a little bit squeamish about the concept of killing video game animals. Until then, have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you next time at the Lapis Kingdom. Bye.